go tall to short.
The station, they had musical artists, Christian musicians that would sing. And second chapter of Acts, interestingly enough, was one of the groups. It was two sisters and a brother. But they, anyway, they're the foundation of War of Love. When we started War of Love, there was that album. It was just right there already. It kind of outlined the story, but didn't cover all the details of it. So we started with that, and we began to add. And when we added the Penitents, I had heard, I think it was the Young Messiah. They did a version of Handel's Messiah, but it was called the Young Messiah, and they did it on CBN station. And that song was in there. It was it's from Messiah, as you know, but it's just updated, or it's contemporaryized, whatever. And so that's that is such a powerful part of the Bible. I mean, from Isaiah.
I would say that it's a very sorrowful, grief kind of role, but it's also, it's like, it's beautiful grief in a way, because you, it's like, in this world we have sin, and then you just kind of, I don't know if everybody has this moment where you realize that, you know, we're all at fault and we all need God in our lives, and that's what that dance is realizing that.
I remember the first year we did it and how powerful it was. It is the story of kind of representing that we are the ones who put Jesus on the cross. We're the ones who sent Aslan to his death. He took that upon him for us. And it always reminds me of my role in that because of my sins and also of God's amazing mercy.
I was like, okay, we're at the foot of the cross. What does that look like? You are in the dirt and you're staring at the cross, which is been pounded into the gravel. Mm-hmm. And I think once you think of that, it's really easy to get into character.
Oh, yeah.
It's a rather jarring number. It's very intense. It's not just a solemn, we're all very sad. It's a very intense, very emotional piece. The pace is constantly changing. The directions are constantly changing. And it's very relational. And the thing that's also kind of almost disturbing is that it's not just one person mourning. It's a whole group of women crying together, and they're all sharing together and reacting off of each other. And they don't keep it to themselves. They don't keep that grief to themselves at all. At the very end, they hand it right to the audience. And they don't even ask for permission. They are saying, we're handing this to you.
As the lead penitent of the penitent dance, it opens the second act of the ballet. It comes just after Aslan's been killed, and the mood is very heavy, very sorrowful. But the piece basically describes how Christ bore our sins and paid the ultimate sacrifice by dying on the cross for all of us.
One time in rehearsal, Miss Jessica was running our rehearsal, Mr. Ron's daughter, and she explained to us it's all the women mourning at the cross. And that always really stuck with me, like Mary Magdalene. And so when I was the wailing girl my senior year, that's how she explained that role to me. And that was really impactful. So every time I performed in the Penitents dance, I've always thought of the women mourning at the cross for Jesus.
The first few folks that you see, are in hooded capes. They're covering themselves. You don't know who's who on stage until a certain part of the scene. because they're ashamed, kind of, ultimately coming into the scene just because of what all has happened, leading up to this point. Typically, I'll just try to stay in the wing and kind of put up my hood. and truly, I think that hood is so, it's important for me to truly, that feels like I'm truly focused and I'm in the zone and in that moment, making sure we're good to go for the scene.
I think a lot of people, when they choreograph, the music takes them places, and they go, oh, I can so see some girl running out and throwing herself on the floor, you know, wailing, which goes back to the cross. You can imagine that happening.
I am the wailing girl in the dance, so I just have a little 8 count where I do my own little thing. I have to do a split. I was really nervous to do that at first, coming back after 20 years, but it's coming back to me, so it's really fun to do. Yeah.
She's always going to have a special place in my heart. One, because she's, the older you get, the more you go through life, I think the penitent and the penitents in general just become so much more relatable. Mm-hmm. But it's been a blessing to be able to kind of figure out how I want to take her on any time. That's been a real awesome privilege to have.
War of Love has some great memories for me. The story itself is a very special story. The ability for us to use our God-given gifts of dancing to tell the story of Aslan, the story of Jesus, has just been an amazing gift.
It means everything because this is my happy place, honestly. It's so much more than just a ballet school to me.
It's something that even if I didn't have children or myself that had the opportunity to come back and participate, it would be one that I still would come, you know, to see.
Yes, definitely worth seeing. It's something that I've been a part of. It's been a part of my whole life. You know, my family's been so involved in it from the beginning. We always just try our best to get there every year and watch it. And just the legacy that Ron and Kathleen have left in this community is just really awesome, and the fact that I get to be a part of it is just really cool.
It's an incredible dance, and our director, Mr. Ron, he made it up.
Yep.
And I think you should get a Tony for it, and that's just my opinion.
Couldn't agree more.
I really like War of Love because The Chronicles of Narnia has always been one of my favorite book series, and I absolutely love the first and second books. They're my favorite, so it's so meaningful that Mr. Ron created the second book into a whole ballet performance, and I really enjoy telling the story. Oh, was that good?
Yes. Good.
Okay.
Okay.
Good.
I particularly bring the alumni back when it's appropriate. I think there are years that we haven't, but we work them in. If we had, alumni that wanted to, but this year is a special year, so we're bringing two full casts of it. But they've all gone through the dance process, and now they've gone on to their lives beyond the studio. So they're, into college. Some are in careers. Some have families. They have gone through more of the realities of life, and so.
You're gonna make me cry.